Jonathan Paula presents Game Time. Greetings, Hotshot, and welcome back to my Uncharted 4 Let's Play on the PlayStation 4. Let's continue where we left off in the last video.
Oh, wherever did I just booby trap?
Oh, hell.
Oh, my gosh.
God damn it.
Are you okay?
Yeah, so far, so good.
I've been better.
Yeah, just stay a little ways back.
Yeah.
Now, what activates these things?
Crap.
Oh, Jesus!
You okay?
Yeah. Well, now we know what caused the explosion we heard earlier.
No wonder so many parts of this passage have caved in.
Avery was a bit paranoid.
Hey, Nate. I found a shortcut.
Yeah, I found it first.
Trying to be optimistic here.
Huh. All right.
All right, let's go. Lead the way, sweetheart. Well, that was it. I wanted an adventure. Goonies never say die. All that stuff, you know? One-Eyed Willy's gold.
Jesus.
That magic keyboard thing. In the dark
decorated this
land
too.
Of skeleton hands. The hands, the hearts that hardened against me. So these are all... Oh, these are all rib cages and hearts. What a Looney Tune! He had quite a bit of paranoia, this Mr. Avery. He was basically insane. Totally.
Shit. We're mummies that go boom.
Which means that's the correct path, which means let's go back this way and look for treasure. There are two in this chapter. I am determined to find them on the first playthrough. Because this is creepy. Let's minimize the time we have to spend here.
Great. Don't explode, okay?
Just careful.
What did I just say?
No!
Oops. Am I supposed to roll forward or roll backward?
Damn it, more mummies.
All right, this time let's just go really fast. Oh no, Jesus. Okay, well, it's a good thing we're playing this on easy mode because I definitely should be dead. Just pretend I dodged those.
Christ's sakes.
Jesus.
Oh, this can't be healthy to breathe. Fine. Fine. I wish I brought earplugs. Am I yelling?
That's solid voice acting there. It even sounds like he can't hear himself. There's something about the way he's speaking. Oh, what's this?
Nate, careful.
Yeah. Man, Avery's gone all Egyptian. Except this mummification wasn't, you know, voluntary.
It was involuntary. Yes, yes, I believe we understood that. Do any of these side rooms have treasures? This one does. How about that? Way to go, Mr. Hotshot. You have found an ancient stone vessel here in Chapter 19. How would Cosell with your treasure update? Back to you, Mr. Drake. Thank you, Howard. I knew we would find you somewhere in this deep, dark cave all along the mummies and stuff. It's nice to see you weren't mummified along with them. I do my best. All right, then. Good to know.
Well, we're back on the trail.
Footprints go this way.
Be ready for a fight.
Oh, I always am.
Is that in reference to me?
No, would you calm down?
You calm down.
So we can't get up there, can we? This is they came down from here, and we're not meant to go up. So, we follow the footprints in this direction. just a little, little cave exploration. Good way to spend a Sunday afternoon with your wife, who you estranged from doing crazy shit like this on a regular basis.
Guess these guys weren't paying attention.
Ugh.
There's no sign of Sam.
Well, it's good then.
We'll find them.
Oh. What do we have here? All right, keep your torch above water.
Oh, hell. Elena, get down! You idiots trying to bring the whole place down!
They say there's more than one way to skin a cat. More than a couple ways to take down a bunch of guys. I was trying to do a few more hip fires than usual. Because I just remembered there is a trophy for hip firing a certain number of enemies, and I haven't done a lot of that in this playthrough. Mostly just stand behind cover and shoot them one at a time. Hip fire doesn't really offer any strategical advantage unless you really want to run and gun. Literally. Oh my god! Welcome to the party, pal! Dun 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 dun. You guys think you can get the drop on me?
Elena, get behind something!
Oh, this is like a boss battle, huh? Look at this big guy. Woo!
Once I appreciate Avery's exploding mummies.
Indeed.
Let's go get those flares.
Good idea.
The mouse that spoke ill of me.
I'd hate to see this guy's Christmas tree.
Hey-o.
I don't see any footprints. We must be on a different route than the others.
All right, let's see if we can catch up.
All right, which way are we going, you think? Looks like there's a couple different paths here. We can go straight through. Let's go straight through first. This is just, like, super creepy. Reminds me of that time my friends and I...
Why, hello.
Hey. So I guess this loops around?
Guess so.
I guess so, yes, indeed.
Jesus. This was one of Avery's guys.
Dead men tell no tales.
Dead men tell no tales. That's a good name for a chapter. For a thing. You mean dead men tell no tales. There we go. Alright, let's head back. Came from that direction. So this just loops around. Nothing big there. This is where we dropped in, so yeah, we do have to go back. Anyway, this reminds me of the time Ezra, Joe, and I snuck into
Looks like the fight broke out.
Shut up, yeah, I'm trying to tell a story.
Two's men versus Avery's.
This reminds me of the time Joe, Ezra, and I snuck into a section of the Queen Mary, ship/museum in Long Beach, California that we weren't supposed to be in. It had been, it had just hosted like the annual like Halloween like ghost tour. So they take over the entire like bowels of the ship, the engine room and all like the extra areas down beneath. And they turn it into a haunted house tour. And the first week of November when we went, they hadn't cleaned it up yet. So they just closed it off. And I think somehow, accidentally, we had found ourselves in this area. Like we opened a door we weren't supposed to. It wasn't labeled no trespassing or anything. We just like opened up. And then, within a couple minutes, like, okay, we probably shouldn't be here. But since we are here, let's keep looking around. And we were exploring an old ocean liner that was shut down. All the lights were off. And all that remained were, like, props of skeletons. It was like we were walking through an abandoned haunted house, which was extra creepy. Because we weren't supposed to be there. And at any moment, we could have got caught and thrown off the ship. And It was a pretty fucking cool experience, I gotta say.
Excuse me?
And I think I actually have photos of it on my Facebook, if you are curious. Oh, a key!
Some kind of key.
The kind that might open a door.
Oh, right.
I didn't think this level had any notes. Let's give it the good old-fashioned read.
It's from two to his men.
Lieutenant Barton, even now Avery is readying his escape. If we allow him to leave these shores, he will surely disappear along with the treasure. Hey, shut up.
Good.
I'm trying to read. I'm in the middle of reading. It's very rude when you interrupt. He will surely disappear along with our treasure. This master key will open the gates in the depths of his tunnels. But be wary, Lieutenant. He will no doubt expect us to pursue him. While you and your men search the tunnels, I shall take a small detachment of men through the valley so we may cut off his escape. If God grants us victory, by sundown tomorrow we shall be pirates once more, sailing to unknown ports with the treasure in our hold, the wind in our sails, and the freedom to live as we choose. Godspeed, Captain Thomas Two. You know, I really wonder. Death to those...
There's some symbols on the back.
...who stray from the path.
Let's go find a keyhole.
Death to those who stray from the path. Death to those who stray from the path. That's a good... It's a good video title as well. I was going to say, the story, like, there's two stories, right? There's Nate's story, then there's Avery's story. They're sort of being told in parallel as the game progresses. And at the end of the game, we're going to know what happened to Avery and his treasure and what happens to Nate, Elena, and Sam. But what's interesting with the pirate narrative, like, they keep fighting over all this treasure, and it's sort of like, why do you want the treasure? It just seems like it's more good, more harm than good, like... So you have all these riches. What do you do with them?
Oh, boy.
What, do you spend them on stuff? Like, what's the point? I don't really get it. Like, you form your own society where you don't even need currency and you want for nothing. So what's the point of having all this gold just to say you own it? It's like people who have giant Blu-ray or video game collections when they, like, have no intention of ever watching or playing any of them. They just own them to say they own them. And I guess there is something to be said about that stuff. Oh, Jesus.
I'm okay.
But at the same time, it's sort of like, all right, you're just sort of collecting for the sake of collection. And it's and in this case, it's a collection that everyone else wants to kill you for. So maybe, I don't know, put down the gold trinkets and just enjoy what you need, not what you want. It might have been the undoing for Captain Avery. I like that just by changing the way Nate sees this environment.
Did it explode now? Huh? No? How about you?
This guy had some serious trust issues.
Indeed. I was saying by changing what Nate uses... I'm going to take a screenshot here of Mr. Nate Drake. This is a good shot right there, right? Look at that, huh? Look at that. It's interesting, like, with the torch, like, it gives it a much different vibe. Well, that's actually kind of a cool shot right there, right? Nate Drake. This can be the thumbnail for the video right here. Huh, right? Just zoom in. Can I zoom in? No, I'm already all the way zoomed in. Oh, that's all right. It's good enough, I think. Yeah, right there. That's fine. Whatever. It doesn't need to be anything fancy. Yeah, it's interesting because earlier in the level, we used a torch. So everything was orange and it had a sort of romantic vibe, as Nate described it. And now we have this like cold blue hue, and it does. It gives the game like a different... It makes this area feel a little bit different.
Oh God, oh God, oh God!
Oh Jesus.
Okay. Done.
Nice moves.
She was standing right there. You should be dead. You should be dead, Elena. All right, we get it. All right, the wood's crickety. You can stop making noise now. Thank you. All right, so there's nothing in here. All right, so you jump down. You're supposed to jump over this, and they just keep running and escaping. And just keep my eye out for that second treasure. You never know when it's going to show up. Another 20-foot drop into a dark part of the cave. Like, how far into the earth are we here? Now, what's this?
Huh. Not quite as creepy as all the hanging bones.
Still, it's a little creepy.
Yeah, maybe 3 out of 10, though.
I'd say 4.
Really, 4?
Mm-hmm.
This game keeps things light. I'll give it that. Woo! Here we are. How about that? You have found the second of two treasures in Chapter 19. A Muggle decorative cudgel, whatever that is. How would Cosell with your treasure update? Back to you, Mr. Drake. I think it's curious that Howard doesn't know what the treasure is, even though he's the one announcing it. Well, I never said I knew things about treasure. I am just really good at counting.
Oh, my ears are popping.
Yeah, we're definitely descending.
Well, thank you for that, Howard. Dun 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 dun.
Another death trap.
Another death trap.
Footprints.
Death trap. You have any?
Didn't you say?
You were saying, Elena?
Didn't you?
Oh
my God! Nate!
I didn't actually mean to hit it. I was trying to go around her, and she got in my
didn't
way.
Didn't you say there were symbols on that letter?
That's right.
Which letter was it? Was it this letter?
The symbols match the ones on those posts. Two showed his men how to get past the traps.
All right, so pirate ship, deadly, top two. Pirate skull, bottom right. The three crosses, everything but top left. Do you memorize all that? Because we're going to have to memorize. We're going to have to memorize it. All right, let's close the journal. So, everything but the top left. We got to jump. Oh! Okay, maybe it's not a matter of jumping. Maybe it's just I picked the wrong one at the outset. So this is the skull and crossbones, which was everything except the bottom right. So these two are fine. Bottom right.
Okay, we're off to a good start. Follow my lead, okay?
Just be careful.
Bottom two?
I'm always careful.
Says the guy who set off every mummy bomb in this place.
Well, you know, not a lot of experience with the mummy bombs. Thank you.
Shit. All right. Oh, this works.
So far, so good.
Yeah, knock on wood.
Bottom
better
right.
Not, it might be rigged.
Yeah.
Yeah, we
there.
Did it.
Made it.
Hey.
Your face, Avery.
I was going to look around for treasure, but and it occurred to me, we already have 2 for 2. It is helpful going into the chapter knowing how many you have to find. But unfortunately, you have to go all the way back out to the main menu screen to get that information, so...
That's our way out of here.
Really? You just dropped the flare so quick?
God, are those the rest of 2's men?
Yeah, gotta be. We know Avery likes to make an example of his enemies.
He definitely likes making exploding mummies.
Is that a joke? Are you being funny? This is not funny, Elena. This is serious business. This is serious business right here.
This is some creepy goddamn shit. Creepy shit.
Yeah. Let's tread carefully in here.
This feels like the beginning of a new chapter. Chapter 20, perhaps. But who knows, this could go on for another half an hour.
Just open the big scary mummy door and see where it takes you. Are we still deep underneath the earth?
Key.
Wait, it could be a trap.
We really don't have much of a choice.
Oh, boy.
Well, one of us should leave.
I have a good feeling about this one.
We don't both have to blow up.
Yeah?
All right.
Do it.
Oh, good. His name is Nate Drake.
You see?
Uh-oh.
Well, at least we didn't get blown to bits. Shit. You didn't bring a knife by any chance, did you?
No. Oh, but that guy's got a sword. Here, help me swing this thing.
This looks pretty sexual. No, oh my gosh, I almost had it.
What?
Oh, I almost had
it.
We're going to die!
Come on.
Shit.
Nate,
hurry. Yes! Shit! We're running out of time! Oh, brother. Reminds me of Crash Bandicoot. Jesus Christ!
Keep running! Right behind you!
Nate! Move your ass! Let's go!
Oh.
Come on! Get up!
Is Elena okay? She looks like she's knocked
Thanks,
out.
Captain Avery. It's just like old times, huh? Elena? Hey. Elena, come on. Elena.
My hero.
Oh, no, you didn't do that. No, that's not funny.
Oh, you have done much worse.
She gave me a goddamn heart attack.
Oh, let me listen. Sounds good to me.
You realize
I think they're
now even for everything I've ever pulled, right?
Everything?
Yeah, like ever.
No, not by a long shot. Gosh, you've got mud everywhere.
I think they've made up anyway.
Anyone ever tell you you have a funny idea of romantic?
Yeah, I may have heard that somewhere before.
Good talk.
Get a panic room, you two.
Good talk.
That's gotta be Sam. Come on.
Ain't no rest for the weary. That does it for this episode of Game Time. Thank you for watching. My name is John, and I hope to see you next time as we continue Uncharted 4.